Today we're going to talk about how to install stepper drivers. These are the basic two stepper drivers. This is the A4988 and this is the DRV8825. Now there's several different ports that you can use for this. You have the X, the Y, the Z, E0, and E1. Now these are both known as extruder 1 and extruder 2. So a couple of things we have to keep in mind are our jumpers. Now this is the default configuration for the jumpers for the steppers as the board arrives. So what we're going to do is we're going to realign these correctly to the correct pin numbers so that we can use this stepper or this stepper. Now keep in mind this does 1/16th of a step, this does 1/32nd of a step. Okay, before we can actually install the stepper drivers, we need to know from the documentation where the jumpers need to be for each one of the steppers. So down below here it says MS0, MS1, and MS2. Then they have these pink boxes or purple boxes that show which ones are jumped with the jumpers. Okay, I've removed the jumpers for the X and the Y steppers. I've left these in so you can see the contrast. Now we're going to put in the steppers the way that they should be according to the directions. So there's one, or MS0. Here's MS1. And here is MS2. Now you want to do the same thing over here. Okay, here's the underside of the SKR version 1.3. The power is along here. So you can see the enable pin right here for the X stepper. Then you can see the direction pin right here and the ground pin over here. So now we know how to align the stepper drivers for the SKR version 1.3. Okay, before we can install the A4988, we need to know what the pins are called. So we have our direction pin here, our ground pin here, and our enable pin here, which will help us align the stepper driver on the SKR version 1.3. Here's the underside of the DRV8825. For the stepper driver, we have our enable pin here. Then we have over here our direction pin and our ground pin. Okay, now to install the stepper, we're going to flip it over. We're going to find the enable pin. We're then going to rotate it. And we know that the enable pin is over here, so we're just going to line that up. And then we're going to apply a little bit of pressure to put it in place. Now for the DRV8825, we have to verify where it is. So it's over here, so we're gonna rotate it over. And we're gonna place it on the Y stepper port. So let me connect up the steppers real quick here for you. There's a notched connection that you can use on your steppers to align them correctly. And on this one, I don't have a notch because it's a DuPont connector, so I'm just gonna slide it in and match up the wire orders that I see for the other ones. So, the next thing that we need to do is actually load firmware. So, for the Marlin firmware, we obviously have to connect the USB cable. So we're gonna attach the big side to the port right here. And then we're going to attach the small side to the computer and you're gonna hear a beep. Okay, to start with, I'm gonna show you that the USB drive came up for the SKR version 1.3. This is run off the TF drive that's on your SKR version 1.3. As you can see, it says firmware.cur. What that means is it's current firmware. So I just want to remind you of this. After we load the firmware, I'm going to come back to this to show you something. And inside here, I've opened up already the Marlin folder for bugfix 2.x. Inside here, there are a couple of files that we have to pay attention to. Let me show you how to load it real quick though. Normally you go to File, then you go to Open Folder. So your unzipped folder for your firmware, you're gonna open the complete folder. So down here below, we have our source folder. Inside the source folder, we wanna go to the core folder, and then we wanna go to boards.h. Inside boards.h, we want to do a search on SKR, and we have a couple of choices, but the one that we're looking for is board_bigtree_SKR_V1_3. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to go over to the configuration.h file. And we're going to open that up and we're going to search on motherboard. And what we want to do is highlight board_ramps_14_EFB. And we want to paste what we just copied. Next, we want to make sure that we have the right setting for our serial port. In the case of this board, we have to change it to a -1 in order to load the firmware. Then what we need to do is we need to find our stepper drivers. So we're going to do a search on A4988. And as you can see, we have the settings for our stepper drivers right here. So we have our X, our Y, our Z, E0, and E1. So I'm going to uncomment the X. I'm going to remove the comment for Y, and I'm going to remove the comment for Z. And we'll do E0 just to make it complete. Now, as you can see, they're all specified as the A4988 by default. So we need to find the DRV8825 up above and paste it in for our Y stepper. That way they know which stepper drivers they're going to be using. Now I'm going to search on Max Step, I think it is. It might just be Max. There we go. And what it has is default steps per unit. Now, normally this is defaulted to the A4988, so we're gonna change the Y, which has twice the amount of stepping capacity as the A4988, to 160 for the DRV8825. And then we need to go over to PlatformIO.ini, and we need to set up the correct board because it's set for the default of the ramps configuration. So the environment default needs to be changed. So we have to find our chipset down below here. So I'm scrolling down to find the ARM Cortex for the M3, and I'm going to copy LPC1768, and then I'm going to scroll back up and I'm going to paste that in for our environment. And that's all you have to do to set up your configuration. In a few minutes, I'll show you a little bit more about the compiling process. Okay, to verify the build took place, we go to toggle build panel, and as we can see, it says successful. So I'm going to close this back down with toggle build panel, and now I'm going to go over to the USB drive for the SKR version 1.3, and as you can see, there's a firmware.bin. This is the new compiled file, and this is the current old one, so watch the time on it. I'm going to remove the USB and then reconnect it, and then we'll recheck it. And now the time has been updated to 5:24 on today's date. So we know that something uploaded with the firmware. Okay, off camera, I connected the power supply and now I'm gonna plug it in. Now remember, for safety, not to touch the board. Okay, I'm in the Pronterface folder. I'm gonna open up Pronterface. I'm gonna connect to the 3D printer board for the SKR version 1.3. And as you can see, it said connecting, and now it says printer is online. Let's verify that we have the right firmware by typing M115 and pressing enter. And as you can see, it says Marlin bug fix 2.0.x. So now I'm going to move the X axis 10 millimeters. Now I'm going to move the y-axis 10 millimeters. And now I'm going to move the x-axis 100 millimeters. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.